Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in Mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to present the essentials of the respect and honor. These two terms are loosely used in society. And people sometimes they don't know where to use the word respect and where to use the word honor. Respect is used for the people who serve you, and honor is used for the people who give you knowledge, as we call in India guru. And I will explain the different stages of the different status of different gurus and all that in another video, but here I'm going to give you a general introduction so you understand the difference between respect and honor. In a society, the greatest respect goes to the woman or your mother, because she brought you into this world and she looked after you when you could easily injure yourself or hurt yourself. So in your tender age, she looked after you, fed you at her own cost. So for looking after you and for serving you while you are a little boy, a little girl, mother earns the highest respect. Now, father is the one who protects you. And we have the physical father, then we have the tribal fathers, and so. So, the feeding, anybody who feeds you is also called a mother. In religious sense, we call Holy Spirit as our mother, because she feeds you, or feeds us, His word, our Father's word. Our Father does not speak, but the tongue of Father is Holy Spirit. So, Holy Spirit speaks His word, not her own word. So, in our family, we have mother, and then we have children, and then we have father. Now, the family is known by the surname of the father, or the seed of the father. So, there are some countries where the surname of the mother is used, and which is not right. Patrilineal. Now the father's name is carried forward in the lineage or in the family, whereas the girl's surname changes on marriage. So, if anything goes wrong in the family, then it is the surname of the father which is used to accuse him or to glorify him. So, the main responsibility of the family falls on the father. So, he instructs his wife or mother how to act or how to behave, and so she instructs the children so that they bring honor to the family, not dishonor. So that's why the head of the family is a man and he is the one who is responsible to educate or to guide the family. Because if he misguides them, then the family can go into bad reputation. If he leads them properly and he himself behaves, that he does not drink or smoke, you know, or waste his life and set a bad example, then it is he who is to be blamed. So the head of the family, the man, then go and learn the spiritual principle or the moral laws from the rabbi. So rabbi will teach only the man the moral laws. The women are just observant in the synagogues and other places. So the teaching of the moral laws is also given to the men because they carry the seed. They have the identification which does not change. The woman's identification changes on marriage. She becomes Mrs. So-and-so. So her identity being not permanent, or so she cannot be given a responsible job of teaching children. When the children are small, they could be misled, and the responsibility of that one falls on the teacher. But today you can see there are lady teachers. Today is the time of conscience of your spiritual. It's a spiritual age. So in this age, it's the conscience of the people that count, and not the gender, or male or female, or this tribe or that tribe. So in this age, in the previous age, the tribal identity or the tribe was by birth, and in this dark age, the tribe becomes by spirit. So what type of spirit you have? Evil spirit bears evil fruit, so it is belong to the evil tribe. So Holy Spirit bears holy fruit, it belongs to a good tribe. So in Jesus or in Christ Nanak, so is the karma which is by the tribe of a person is known by karma, whereas under the Brahmins or under the rabbis, the tribe of the person was known by the birth, wherever he was born. So this is a bit deeper, and it takes explanation of these terms. However, in the family, then we have the mother who feeds you, and anyone who feeds you is called a mother. That's why in India we call a cow or a river Ganges as mother, because both help in the feeding of the people. We are fed on the milk given by the cow, so she is our mother. And same way, camel milk and goat milk and all that which will help you in feed, they are called, classified as mother. And like Ganges, the water of which makes you grow food, we call it Mother Ganges. And our planet itself, the land, is called mother because it grows food. It brings forth food that you eat. So for more fertile the land, the better the quality of food. So in the next video, I will then explain these things in detail and try to bring home the importance of respect and owner.